Good morning.
How are we? We okay?
Newly awake.
Wow. Right, 10 o'clock. Thursday morning. Come on, Caddy. Get on. Get up. Get moving.
Oof.
Bit warm out there, isn't it? This is one of those workouts where I kind of wish I was outside, but I'm kind of glad I'm indoors in the shade. Because it's warm out there and I don't do heat. I wear shorts all year round, especially in snow. I'm happy in the cold, not happy in the heat.
Yeah, that's my moan for the day done. Right, upper body weights blast. You need two weights. Whether that is dumbbells or weight plates or bottles of water.
Always handy. Hang on, my coach is messaging me. Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, coaches have coaches. I've got a coach. Good morning, Lisa.
So, you can do it with two bottles of water. If you have, like these, a 2 litre bottle of water, I've been and weighed these ones, they weigh about 2 kilos each. About 2 kilos each. Which is great, because then you've got 2 kilo weights. If you're really clever, and you really fancy it, then you start collecting water bottles, and you start tying them together, so you can have singles, doubles, triples, so you can get 2 kilos, 4 kilos, 6 kilos, 8 kilos. Just gradually build up your weights collection, all from plastic bottles. See, it's recycling. Okay, this morning's session, 5 rounds. We're gonna do a chest round, one for back, one for shoulders, one for tricep, one for bicep, okay? Each round has 3 exercises, dun, dun, dun. So it'll all get kind of plenty of work for each muscle. And we're gonna do drop time, one of my favorite training styles. I love doing this one. It hurts, it wears you out, but it's great for getting things going. So we're gonna go for 50 seconds work on the first exercise, 10 seconds rest. 50 seconds on the second exercise, 10 seconds rest. 50 seconds on the third exercise, 10 seconds rest. And then we go around it all again, 40 seconds each, and round it all again at 30 seconds each. So that's about seven and a half minutes. And then we pretty much go straight into the next one. I haven't actually put a break in between each round today, which is stupid. Maybe I need to tweak the timer before we start. So, while I tweak that timer, so you actually have time to move and breathe and work out what we're doing, give it a little jog on the squat. Look at this, multitasking. I can play with my phone and I can jog. Who knew I could do more than one thing at a time? Give it a little jog, a little bit of movement. So that last one, if we make it 30 seconds rest eventually instead of 10, perfect. See, it's like a brain cell. It almost works at times.
Almost. Who else is in? Sean's here.
Good morning, Sean. Should have shaken arms loose. That's it. It's enough of the jog. We've done cardio. That was yesterday. Swing your arms back and forth. So just to swing it through, loosen that shoulder out. As it comes up now, as your arms come up, get your hand back behind your head so we can open the tricep up a little bit. So it comes up, reach back, but don't do it quite so slow. Just let it swing through. And smile, for God's sake. Yes, you. Smile, gamble. And then take it wide, reach out to the side. As you reach wide, as we always do with this one, turn your hand over. So you get your little finger at the top, thumb down low, just so we can open the chest a little bit more and get the bicep ready to work. Because it's got plenty to do later. And then take it one arm up, one arm down. So our first 3 exercises, when we hit the floor in a minute, when we get into chest, we're doing flies, where we're gonna go out to the side and back in We're going to do chest press and we're going to do pullovers where we just pull the weight over you.
Hence the name.
Shake your arms loose. Michelle Reese, how are you?
You okay?
So shake you loose. And all I want you to do now is just very quickly, just like a bicep curl, bring your hands up and back. Just swing it back slightly. So as your arm comes back behind you, it opens the bicep, opens the front of the shoulder. Here we are, functional anatomy. Quick way to get a muscle to stretch. Get it to work. Stretch it, switch it on. Boom, it's away and it's working. Do, do, do. See, I charge people a fortune to teach them this on a PT course and you're getting it for free. All right, let's lay it down. Let's get to the floor so we can get into the training. So I'm gonna go sideways. I'm gonna use the lovely purple plates because we can. So our three exercises again. We keep a little bend in the elbow. We've got flies out to the side, up to the top. Always that little bend in the elbow. Second one is gonna be press, where the hands come down to above your elbows, push it nice and wide. And the last one, pullovers, you reach back, you pull over the top of you, reach back, pull over the top of you. Easy. So we start with flies. Ready? Two, one, let's go. So take it out to the side. Your arms need to stop just before you get to the floor. If you want to make it work a little bit extra at the top, turn your hands in so your palm faces you. And it uses the chest just a little bit more. A little turn of the hand as your elbows come in closer to each other. Your chest picks up and works a bit harder. Keep going. Of course, if anybody's sunburned, this probably feels great lying down on a carpet, working across your arms, your chest, your shoulders. And breathe. 10 seconds here. Chest press next. So it's down. Push up to the top. Come on, let's go. If the weight you've got is too light and too easy, like we did last Thursday, slow it down. Feel it work all the way through. Control it that little bit more. Or if you've got the option, grab a heavier weight. Come on, keep pushing. Again, your arms stop just above the floor. Try and feel your chest doing the work here. Two, one, and breathe. Okay, so for the next one, for pullovers, weight above you, reach back, tap the floor, bring it up. Or stop just before the floor. Slight bend in the elbow. So this will work the chest, the muscles in between the ribs, a little bit round your upper back, a little bit round the triceps for the back of the arm. Bit of everything really, which is nice. If you want to add a variety to this, bring it back, then take one arm up at a time so one arm stays outstretched and has to hold that weight. Just off the floor. It's up to you. You could just keep going two together, of course. All right, we go back to the start. So it's back to flies on the next one, but you've got 10 seconds to breathe if you want it. Go. That little bend in the elbow still. Back against the floor. Breathe, smile, enjoy yourself. This is fun, apparently. Come
pulling in towards the centre, like we did earlier. If you want, turn your hands, bring your elbows in together. Get the chest to work a little more as you turn the arm in. And here we go, right, so we're going back to chest press next. 10 seconds to rest if you want it, or just get on with it, come on. Get it done. So your arm comes down just above the floor, push it back up. So you can do this with weight plates, you can do it with bottles of water, you can do it with bags full of books. Kettlebell in each hand. Don't do it with small children or animals. You might drop it. Alright, it's that pull over again. So get that movement, reach it back, and then pull over. Let's go! Same as we did earlier, you've got the option, hold one arm back, and just make it one arm at a time that does the lift. So you've got to keep that tension one side, so hold it. Or you can keep the two together, it's up to you. There we go. All right, last time, we've got to go around it all once more, so we go back to those flies. Let's go. Now we're doing this as drop time, 50 seconds of each, 40 seconds of each, 30 seconds of each. Here's an idea for you. Do this workout again later, or tomorrow, or whenever. Hang on. Right, back to press. But next time you do it, do 50 reps of each, then 40 reps of each, then 30 reps of each. That'll be fun! Yeah, whatever. Come on, let's go, press! Thing is, I know there's some of you out there who'll hear that idea and think, do you know what, Si? Yeah, I'm up for that. That sounds like a great idea. And those people are the ones who are as random as me. Hey, alright, so it's pullovers. 30 seconds of this one, then you get 30 seconds rest. Let's go. So pull that weight across you, still that little bend in the elbow. Keep the stress off the joints. There we go. All right, 30 seconds. Up we get. Come on, up we go. Maggie, how are you, darling? So, let's stand it up. Next round. We've got three exercises. Bent over row. Bent over raise for the back of the shoulder. And deadlift for the lower back. Bent over row first. Lean it in. Put it back. Pull your elbows back towards your waist, back towards your hip. Knees bent. Chest lifted. So this is working the upper back. Back of the shoulder. A little bit for the bicep. Although we're finishing the workout with biceps later. Do it at the end. To keep
those knees bent, hips back, chest lifting, pull it through. Maybe a little pause when you lift. And then reach down low at the front. So you can let it stretch the upper back, right behind the shoulder. And breathe. Okay, so your next one, same position. We're going to keep your thumbs in together. Put your hands apart. So it comes across, we work the back of the shoulder. Let's go. So pull your hands away from each other. But keep your thumbs on the inside. With your thumbs in at the middle, as you pull your hands apart, we get the back of the shoulder to work that little bit more. If you have your palm facing each other, it changes the effect. It misses the bit we're really looking for. 15 seconds, come on. Two, one, bend your knees, stand it up, deadlift next, that little bend in the knee, tip forwards, stand it up, go. So that little bend in the knee all the time, push your hips back, keep your shoulders back, so when you stand it up, your chest is lifted nice and proud. We're working hamstrings, glutes, and lower back. They all tie in together. Come on, just over 10 seconds to go. Four. Three, two, one. So we're back into that bent over row next. Knees bent, hips back. Pull it up, 40 seconds. Let's go. How are we all feeling? We're starting to warm up a little bit now. Or is it just me? Come on, keep those legs bent, keep those hips pushed back. Pull the elbows back towards your hip. Little pause as your arm comes back. 10 seconds. And breathe, up again. Okay, so it's that bent over sideways or bent over raise. Thumbs in the middle. Get out to the side. Go. Come on, keep your knees bent. Put your hands apart. Just focus on that. Rather than trying to lift the weight or anything, take your hands away from each other. That little bend in the elbow all the time. Your shoulder will do the work for you. Four, three, two. Stand it up, it's deadlift next. Little bend in the knee. Go. Come on, keep it going. So this is 40 seconds on this. We've got to do each exercise 30 seconds. And then we'll move it on. 7 seconds to go. Alright, we're a third of the way through the workout already. So it's that bent over row. Lean it over. Pull it up. No. Always that little pause once you've pulled it in. So your back can do the work and hold the weight up. And rest. Okay, for the next one, pull your hands apart. Go! So this is a bent over raise. Gets the back of the shoulder. Smile. Go on. If you want a little pause when you lift it up, make it work. 10 seconds to go. And rest. Okay. Last one for back. Deadlift. 30 seconds here. Go. Keep that little bend in the knee. Push your hips back. Doesn't matter how low that weight goes down. It could be just below your knee. You can get it all the way to the floor. You go with your own range of movement. 4, 3, 2. There we go. All right, grab a quick drink if you need it. We're doing shoulders next. This one's gonna be fun. So we've got side raise, bringing the weights up shoulder height. We've got front raise, bringing it up shoulder height. And then we've got press above us. Side raise, go. So lift it up, little bend in the elbow. Same as we did when we were bent forwards. Just think about pulling your hands apart, yeah? If you can as well, try and think about keeping your shoulders down. So we're not letting your shoulders bounce up and down. We're not doing the chicken dance. Your hands come apart, your shoulders stay fairly level, fairly flat. Too warm, don't make excuses. Give me 6 months, you'll be telling me it's too cold. Bring it up, little pause and down. 3, 2, 1, here we go. Woo. All right, front raise. If you want, split your stance, 1 foot forwards. Bring it up, shoulder height, and down. Nice and steady. When it comes down, try not to let it swing back and then swing up. Bring it down, try and stop in front of you. Bring it up, pause, down, pause, up. So all movements are deliberate. If you want, turn your hands in to face each other. Just means the front of the shoulder and the bicep work a little more here. Yes, front raise will recruit the bicep. Yes, personal trainers are now going to slate me. You can't say that. Trust me, it works. All right. Shoulder press. Your challenge here, keep the weight shoulder width so it doesn't come into the middle at the top. I want it kept shoulder width. The weight should just go up and down, fairly straight line. All the work is going to stay in the front of the shoulder. A little bit through the tricep. How are we feeling? Besides warm, Sean. We all okay? Is dun, dun, dun. Push it, come on. We're nearly there. Told you. 2, 1, bring it down. Shake it loose. Side raise. 40 seconds. Oof. Bring it up. Little pause at the top. The time starts now. So lift it up. Little pause. Bring it down. Trust me, the next round, the tricep round, that's going to be fun. Yeah, I would say that. Because I've got issues. Get those elbows out. Don't just lift your hands up to the side. There we go. Feeling the burn. Yeah, sunburn. Front raise. Pick it up. Let's go. Little pause at the top. Shoulder height. Only that slight bend in the elbow. So the joint isn't taking the strain. Who comes up with these ideas for these workouts? Oh, wait. Me. It's not my fault. Coffee made me do it. We could be worse, we could be going really, 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 really slowly like we did last Thursday. That hurt. Oof. Alright, shoulder press. This time at the top, cross your hands over. Alternate that front hand. Let's go. So you get your arms right in close to your head or in front of you. Cross over, so we can get all the shoulder to work on this. Come on. Give it a little more, only a few seconds to go. And breathe. Alright, side raise. Bring it up, shoulder height, little pause and down. It's that pause in the middle, palm facing the floor, that makes it work. That little bit extra. Get that burn. Switch those muscles on. Come on. Nice. All right, front raise next. Split your stance if you need to. Bring it up, shoulder height. And back down. You can have your palms facing each other. You can have your palms down. Whichever you prefer. Just as long as you're moving. Seconds. Come on, let's keep going, let's keep going. Yeah, starting to work now. Alright, shoulder press. This time we're going to put the Y in Y. It's going to push out to the corners. Bring the weight into your shoulder. Push it out wide. Why is there no Y in wide? I don't know. Stupid question, it runs on my head every time I think you're doing this one. Push it out, little pause, bring it in. If anyone knows the answer, why there's no why in why, let me know. Be nice to know. Besides the spelling, obviously. Dumbass. Alright, so 30 seconds rest. Triceps next. We're doing extensions overhead to start with. Then we're going to do kickbacks. We're going to lean forwards, arms up, two hands. They're both going to kick out, yeah? And then we finish it
We're going to hold it about halfway. It's an isometric hold. Good luck. Extensions overhead, 50 seconds. Go. Get low as you can, get high as you can. So this really kicks into the back of the arms. Elbows pointing to the ceiling, upper arm close to your head. What's Sean on about now? I was just about to spell it for me. I knew you would.
Thanks.
Come on. All the way down, all the way up. Keep those upper arms close to your head. Two. One, bring it down. All right, kick back, bend your knees, lean forward, upper arm next to your body, push back. Come on, give it a little squeeze as you push it back. Get the back of the arm to really pull in here. We're flying through this workout. It was 38 and a bit minutes long. There's only 14 left to go, which is nice. Keep your knees bent. Lean it forwards. Keep that upper arm fixed next to your body. Squeeze it back. Get the back of the arm to work. Seven, six, five. Now it's the fun one. Bring it up. We're going to lift it about halfway and hold it there. Go on, hold it up. I'll go there so you know I'm not actually cheating, I'm not resting behind my head. You're looking for about a 90 degree bend in the elbow. The tension, you should feel it in the tricep, you're trying to hold that weight. It'll feel alright for now, later on it might start to kick in a bit. If it's too easy, go a little bit lower, deep into that stretch, and then push up slightly. So you work from the bottom of the movement. Come on, we can do it. Keep that tension, don't let it rest. You've got to keep pushing against the weight. 10 seconds. This loads the tricep up, ready to work more later. Ready? Breathe, 10 seconds rest. Extensions overhead, so we're back in that position, but now it's that full movement. Pump it through, come on. All the way down, all the way up. It's only 40 seconds. You might start to feel your triceps get a little bit warm and tingly soon. But that's okay. Going. All the way down, all the way up. Oh, that's my phone ringing. And bring it down. Lean it forwards. Kick back. Go. So push your arms back. Lock it out, bring it down. Upper arm close to your body. Fixed in place. Push it back. Squeeze the tricep, the back of the arm. How are you feeling? You okay? You still in there? And breathe, up we go, okay. It's that hold. Push it up halfway. Keep it here. Go. So you gotta keep pushing against the weight a little bit. Arms close to your head.
Stop swearing.
Yeah, you.
Woo! 20 seconds.
It's not dancing, should we?
No, it's not. Come on, keep that tension. Don't let it drop. Don't let it rest. Push against it. It's only 10 seconds. Gotta love isometrics. Pumps out the blood, pumps out the muscle. Ah, breathe. 10 seconds rest. Woo! Alright, tricep extensions overhead. Full movement. 30 seconds only. Let's go. Come on, keep moving, keep moving. Halfway! And bring it down. Woo, getting warm now. All right, leaning forwards. Upper arm next to the body, kick wax. Push it back. Little pause. Come on. Try turning your hands, different angles, different positions. See if you feel it a little bit differently. See if you feel it more at any point. Ooh. Nearly there. 3, 2, 1. Finish it off with a hold. See people walking around outside my window. Ooh. Body here. Come on, keep that tension.
Your triceps still hurt from Monday. What the hell did we do on Monday?
Or was it not my workout?
I don't know.
10 seconds. Oh my God, this hurts. Ow. Ow, this is stupid. Who came up with this idea? Some stupid idiot. 2, 1, ow. That was fun. All right, we've got biceps to finish off. Hello, child. Oh, do us a favor. Ring Gran. She just tried ringing me. Okay, so we've got biceps to finish off. Full curl. Then we're gonna do top half, and then we're gonna do bottom half. So, full bicep curl, 50 seconds. Ready, 2, 1, go. See, it's always useful having my daughters here, even if they are dancing around outside, usually. Because now they can do my phone calls for me. I found out why my mum just rung me in the middle of a workout. So, full movement all the way up, all the way down. Come on, try not to swing that weight through. Just get that full motion. It's that stretch at the bottom is the important bit. Strengthen, oh yes! You're right, Monday, strength and endurance was all tricep, yes. Oops, all right, bicep curl, top half. So you're gonna bring it out level to the floor. I'm back. You're right. In a 58 minute workout or whatever it was Monday, triceps were working for about 18. Yeah. Fair play, I'll let you off. That was a bit stupid. So it's that pause to make you work a bit more. Keep your elbows forwards. Because then even when you come down level to the floor, the bicep has to stay loaded a little more, just for fun. And then we go from here, in a few seconds you get to breathe, like about now. Okay, so the last one, number 3, is bottom half only, all the way down, stop in the middle. just that little part of the bottom section. Let's go. Okay. A little squeeze in the middle, all the way down, arms level to the floor. I'm forgiven. Woohoo! You'll have strong arms when they stop hurting. I've given them 3 days to recover, and now we've just tortured them with that last one. I hope you don't tell your clients that I broke you. 10 seconds. Come on. Breathe. So it's full curls next. If anyone's in Cardiff and wants a great female PT, Sean Davis, who's commented here, contact her. Full curls all the way up and down. Let's go. Simon says, if you're in Cardiff and you want a good female PT, look elsewhere. If you want a great one, speak to Sean. There you go. All the way down, all the way up. Come on. What have we got left? Less than 4 minutes to the end of the workout. Hey, the end is in sight. You're nearly free of me. 10 seconds, then we're into that top half. Three, two, one, let's go. Stop in the middle, bring it up. I could become a bit of a snob and say I don't associate with good PTs, only the great ones. But I wouldn't do that. Might be true, but I wouldn't do that. 15 seconds, come on. Keep those elbows forward, little pause. Get the tension on the bicep. 2, 1. Bottom half next, all the way down, halfway up. Stop when it's level to the floor. Come on, 40 seconds, let's go. I know, I just went straight through it. Which really means I need to use heavier weights next time, because this isn't enough of a challenge. Sean, you're always welcome. I'm the world's worst selfish personal trainer. I always recommend everybody else first. It's like, go and train with other people, and if they're really busy, well, then come back to me. Come on. All right, full curls. All the way down, all the way up. It's 30 seconds work. Come on, we can do it. Time starts now. All the way down, all the way up. If you want, give it that little twist at the bottom, twist at the top. Turn your hands facing back, facing forwards. Get that extra little squeeze through the bicep. More of a stretch at the bottom, more of a squeeze at the top. More work, more results. We're all going to be ready for our bikinis next year. Wait, what? I'm not wearing a bikini next year. Summer's coming, summer 2021, here we come. Top half only, let's go. Come on. Just over 10 seconds, it's only the top half. Hold it out, little pause. Do you know what, for fun, just hold it here. Hold it in the middle for another 4, 3, 2, 1. Stop. All right. Bottom half only. 30 seconds and done. Go. Come on. Keep those shoulders down. Hold them back slightly. We've got about 10 seconds to go. Curl it up and hold it halfway. Squeeze it in. You want to make it work more. Push it forward slightly again. 2, 1. We're done. Which means we get to shake it loose and relax and breathe and smile and stuff. My t-shirt mildly stuck to me. That's not good. I'm gonna blame the 20 odd degrees outside, yeah? I'm not unfit. Not that unfit. Just want to shake your arms loose. Little bit of a stretch. Relax everything out a little. How are we all feeling? You okay? So shake your arms loose. And then let's take one arm across the body. Either push the tricep or pull from the wrist. Get that stretch across the body. Quick stretch to the shoulders, the upper back. Just let it all release out. And then we're going to do legs tonight, 5 o'clock. Same kind of style, leg training. Yes, thank you, Sean. I'll see you tonight. I'm here. Let's take that hand back, push it back, get the stretch of the tricep. So tonight's lower body session, 5 o'clock. Again, there's going to be 5 rounds, 3 exercises a round, same kind of timing. Just challenge your lower body differently. Quick session, blast it out, get it done. Bring it down, take the other arm across, quick stretch here. So make sure you go and drink plenty, have a snack, get something to eat. Can't wait, you almost sound excited, Nikki. Almost. Great to see you, let's take it back, push that hand back behind you. It won't be as bad as last week's one where we went really, 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 really super slow on lunges and then couldn't walk for about 3 days. Yeah, that was a clever idea, wasn't it? Bring it down, shake your arms loose. Last one, hands to the back of the head. Head up, chest lifted, squeeze your elbows in behind you. Get that stretch, chest and shoulders. You're welcome, Luis. Get that quick stretch and bring it down, shake your arms loose. Give yourself a round of applause. Go and escape, go and refuel. I'll see you at 5 o'clock. Bye-bye.